There have been many great emotes in the course of human history on that have always been used on twitch.television. Emotes such as this one. This one. This one. And this one. So today, I am going to be teaching you guys YouTube's guide to better TTV emotes. Because one thing I've noticed from the switch from Twitch to YouTube is simple. YouTube doesn't really know how to use Twitch emotes. Like right now, someone's in my chat using face fuchsia tongue out. So I'm going to show you guys the guide to better TTV emotes. There will be a quiz at the end. Yes, this does all matter. Don't question it. Without any further ado, let's get into it. So the first thing I think you all should know, what are we gonna learn? So today, we're gonna learn some of the key better TTV emotes, when to use the emotes, what they mean, and what they are in general. So starting with what they are, better TTV emotes essentially were added to as an extension of Twitch years ago in order to give the chat more universal emotes to create a better culture. And that is kind of the start of that. Since then, it has evolved, and anybody can just upload a BTTV emote, as far as I know. But there are a few key ones we have to cover today, all of which are activated in this chat, so you can use them and try them as we go on. The first one we're going to talk about today is easy. It's the cool little Pepe with the glasses and the leather jacket. Now this emote typically is used when something is done with a lot of ease. Keep in mind, I see you trying to use them in chat. The capitalization does matter. The capitalization in the slides is the correct capitalization. I did not want to mislead you. I did not want to give you fake information. The capitalization is correct and it does matter. Easy is used when the streamer, i.e. me, does something with ease, as in winning a battle in Pokemon, beating a challenge, setting a PR or a PB in a speedrun, etc., etc. Anything that is done with such ease is it calls for easy. Now, next up on the list would be clap. And it is used to applaud the streamer for doing something that is both cool and pog, or one or the other. Think of like giving the streamer a standing ovation, for example. Cool or pog. Now I know what you're thinking. What is pog? We'll get to that. We'll get to pog down the line. Just know, whenever you want to give the streamer a standing ovation, you give him a clap. Easy and clap have a very special relationship, and it is one of many that when you use them back to back, you go easy, clap. That creates what I have deemed a fusion emote, and it simply does mean easy clap. And you use that by, and it means something like, wow, streamer, that looked so easy. I applaud you for doing so well. That is easy clap. So think, I do something, I do a challenge, obliterate it. Looks easy. You're like, I could do that. Easy clap. Usually they are used side by side. I think easy clap is more commonplace in today's world than easy or even just clap. This would be a good college course. Thank you. I made this 15 minutes before going live. Next one is DD huh, and it is used mostly when something surprising or shocking has been said. So if I say something that makes you go, huh? Dee dee, huh? Next on the list. Lol W slash Omega Lol. This is primarily used when the streamer says something funny that make it's like saying LOL, but it's better. The one on your left is Lol W. The one on your right is Omega Lol. Now, Omega Lol is one of those instances that you can, it has greater outreach, okay? Because you can do things like Who Mega Lol? No Mega Lol. There's a lot of outreach you can do with Omega Lol. There's a lot of outreach you can do with Lol W. Next up, Monka W or Monka S. This is when something spooky or unsettling is happening, or when something uncomfortable is happening. You Monka W, or you do a Monka, or you do a Monka's. It's simple. So like if you're going down a dark hallway in a scary game, or if the streamer starts to malt because some dude named Jesus comes into the chat and just starts saying random things for no reason, and we're no elaboration on that one, just a random example I came up with off the top of my head. You just Monka W. What I want you to know by the end of this is using better TTV emotes is easy. It's not complicated. It doesn't have to be difficult. It doesn't have to be a difficult thing. You don't have to get intimidated. It's easy. Next up is Pog, Poggies, and Poggers, baby. So this is the dynamic trio, all right? Up first, we have Pog. Second, we have Poggies. Third, we have Poggers. This is used when something either cool or something exciting is going down on the Twitch stream. Like when, not the Twitch stream, holy fuck. When something cool or exciting is going down on the live stream, such as streamer goes live, Pog. Streamer beats Fire Red, Poggies. There is an addendum to this that I forgot. Another classic you can't forget, right? Streamer beats Fire Red, Pog you. All of these in general mean the same thing. Something cool is going down, right? Something exciting just happened. You were here. It happened. And that's what matters. Next up, I am a big fan of, because he is so cute. This is such a cute emote. It is simply Peppo G. This emote is used whenever the streamer is enlightening the chat and or making them smarter as a whole. As in, if I'm playing chess. Or right now, I am enlightening you guys. I am enlightening you. I am teaching you something. You are all going to walk out smarter people. So now would be a good time. Peepo G. Or if I am dropping knowledge such as how I'm going to beat Pokemon Fire Red. Peepo G. Like you're taking notes. Or if I say, chat, take a note of this. Peepo G. Next up, Prage. So Prage is used whenever, like, think of Goku charging his spirit bomb. This right here. Like, when this is happening, when this is going down. And he's telling everyone, and Goku's telling everyone, I need your energy. I need you to give me your energy. It's the same concept when you're using a Prage, right? You're giving the streamer the energy they need to complete the task. When something has got to happen, you hit a Prage. Cringe? Look, I got flamed for not watching anime. Now I'm getting flamed because I brought up an anime. There's no winning. I can't win. The next emote, or emotes, I should say, are Madge and Sag. These emotes are used to simply convey the emotion that can be seen and is referenced to in the name, such as mad or sad. You are Madge or you are Sage. Think about when a Pokemon dies, Sage. When a run is thrown, Sage. When the streamer doesn't listen to you, Madge. Right? Whenever you are feeling those two emotions, Madge and Sage. Now this one's important. Let's go. Alright. When the streamer starts popping off, when the chat is popping off, when you're rallying for your streamer, you're throwing a let's go in there, right? You're cheering them on. When the streamer beats a game, you're cheering them on. That is the purpose of this emote, is to cheer on the streamer. Keep in mind, these are just a handful of the options that are available to you as a chatter. These are just a handful of options. I implore you to look at the list of options, find some you like, and report them back to me. Because we covered the essential ones today, but there are so many more that you could use, like Cat Jam when bangers are playing. All right? Cat Jam, Pepe Jam, Pepe D, Blob Dance, all of them when bangers are playing. Then there's others, such as, so there are plenty. I implore you, okay? Go through, find some you like, report it back, all right? Because there are hundreds of them. Finally, chat, in order to better your understanding, quiz time, baby! Woo! It's quiz time! This is how it's going to work. An emote is going to appear on the screen, but it's been blacked out. Chat must guess which emote it is from the options. Majority rules. At the end, chat, you will be graded on your correctness. Now, it shouldn't be that hard. It will only contain emotes that you have learned about today. You guys ready? You don't remember any? Awesome. Let's go. Good. Question one. Is this A, Lol W, B, Let's Go, C, Sag, or D, Omega Lol? Bro, that's a circle. So the majority says A, it is Lol W. Chat, I regret to inform you, it was actually Omega Lol. It was actually D, Omega Lol. Next question. Is this Monka S, Monka W, Poggies, or EZ? You guys think it's D? Well, chat, I'll have you know. Got one on the board. Woo! All right, next up. Is this Poggers? Is this Sag? Is this Peppo G? Or is this Lol W? Oh, man. It's split between Sag and Peppo G. You guys think it's C? You guys think it's Peppo G? Well, chat, you were correct. Go chat. Look at that, guys. See, maybe you guys did learn something. Congratulations. See, it was easy. It was four questions. You have officially completed the guide to better TTV emotes. Congratulations to you, chat. You guys got 2 out of 3. You got a 66. That's okay. You messed up on the hard one. I'm proud of you guys. I'm proud of chat. That's failing. Not over here. Not in Streamerville. It's not. It's passing. Nope.